Good morning. Thank you for joining us here at the University of Waterloo for the Women in Physics Canada Conference. I'd like to start by acknowledging that we are on the traditional territory of the Neutral, Anishinaabeg, and the Haudenosaunee peoples. The University of Waterloo is situated on the Haldimand Tract, land promised to Six Nations, which includes 6 miles on each side of the Grand River. My name is Kevin Resch, and I'm the director of the Institute for Quantum Computing. I'm delighted that IQC is hosting this year's Women in Physics Canada conference. At IQC, we aim to build a safe, welcoming, and inclusive community that encourages everyone to participate in advancing the field of quantum information science. Each year, we welcome students, faculty, staff, and visitors from around the world. And we have a community based on diverse academic fields, perspectives, backgrounds, and ideas that continue to propel Canada as a leader in developing transformative quantum technologies. This morning, I have the pleasure of introducing our Member of Parliament, Leader of the Government in the House of Commons, and Minister of Small Business and Tourism, the Honorable Bardish Chagger. Minister Chagger is a proud University of Waterloo alumna and strong supporter of science in Canada. Please join me in welcoming the Honorable Bardish Chagger.
Good morning, everyone. Come on. Good morning, everyone. This is like where it's at. This is like the future of our country, and it feels so good to see so many more women in the room than I see men. So one day, this is what I believe our offices and our labs and everything will look like, and we have a lot of work to get there. And Kevin, thanks for that introduction, and thanks for having me here this morning. And I really want to thank our hosts, the Institute of Quantum Computing and the Department of Physics and Astronomy here at the University of Waterloo. And I want to take a moment to acknowledge that you did acknowledge the land. And this is why I love the University of Waterloo. No matter how amazing people believe we are and know we always strive to do more and better things. And it's pretty impressive. And this is a new page that we've turned to show that we are acknowledging the land to really build our relationships. And that's why I believe that when it comes to making a difference, it will be here at the University of Waterloo that we will continue to lead. And it's such a pleasure to join you this morning at my alma mater to bring greetings on behalf of my friend and colleague, the Honorable Kirsty Duncan, Minister of Science. Conferences like this are incredibly important for women in science, especially in your case, women physicists. This is a great opportunity for women to come together, to learn from one another's experiences in the research community, to network with each other, and to provide encouragement and support to the next generation of women scientists just beginning their careers. And I saw a really young future women scientist in this room, and I was so impressed, because I think that's really what it comes down to, is that when we do, you know, let our nieces and nephews and our children to really be part of it, that we can actually help broaden their scope and allow them to know that they belong here. So it's never really too soon. And having this kind of support network can really make a difference. You have all chosen to persevere in a field where women and other minority groups are constantly underrepresented. And I know this firsthand. I remember in grade 6, I was a student at Sandown, and the University of Waterloo hosted a Day with the Difference. And this was a day for young women to come to the University of Waterloo to travel through the hallways here and to meet women in science. And you were able to meet women in many different fields of science. And that was the day that I felt that I belonged in science. And that was actually the day that I decided that I'd be going to the University of Waterloo when I graduated high school, and I'd be going into science. And that really speaks about leaving an impression early in life. And when I went to the University of Waterloo in science, and I focused really on bio and chemistry, there was a lot more women that were there than when my aunt had gone to the University of Waterloo. And what I know by still coming and visiting on a regular basis is that there is still room to grow. But we have made great strides. And we will continue to prove that there is no challenge too great to overcome, and that women belong and are needed in every field of study. And now that I'm a woman in politics, I can tell you that we need more women in politics. So I always want to now plant that seed as well, because it changes the conversation. Our prime minister brought gender parity to the cabinet table, and what it has done is it's changed the tone and the conversation. And it's really not just about today and winning political points, but it's really about developing the country that we want to live in, and to really recognize that what we do here really impacts other communities and other countries. So we have a role on the international play. So needless to say, I can certainly understand the kinds of issues you face, but I can also understand the rewards that you reap. And I want to congratulate each and every one of you for your continued contributions. I think we can all agree that despite the progress we have made, there is still much work to do. And I really hope that we all do it together. Now, I want you to know that our Prime Minister, the Right Honorable Justin Trudeau, and the Government of Canada completely support you. This is not just a policy agenda for our Prime Minister. It goes to his core. As an elected official, as a son, a husband, a father of three children, two boys and one girl, and as a person, but most importantly, as a Canadian. Our Prime Minister is a committed feminist, and I can assure you that the Government of Canada, your Government of Canada, is full of feminists as well. And I'm very proud of the fact that our government is taking important steps to address gender inequalities, including in the scientific community. Recently, we instituted new equity requirements in the Canada Research Chairs and Canada Excellent Research Chairs program. And we have launched the Choose Science, hashtag Choose Science campaign to encourage more underrepresented groups, especially women and girls, to enter STEM careers. So that's hashtag Choose Science. And I encourage each of you to use that hashtag to post a picture of yourself or other women and girls in science so that future generations can also see themselves in science. And as living proof, I can tell you it makes a difference. When you can see yourself at the front of a room, it makes you strive to want to do more, to push a little bit harder, and to ensure other people have that opportunity. And as a woman in politics, I'll tell you, I never thought I would run. And oftentimes I was told that I shouldn't run and I couldn't win. But here we are today. We ran, we've lost a couple of times, but that has only made me succeed and want to go further. I always say that failure is just success in the making. So I encourage you to use that hashtag to really support the work that Minister Duncan and the Government of Canada is doing, the work that you are doing every single day, to let future generations see themselves in fields of science, in STEM, because I know we can change the numbers there for sure. And we do this because we know that Canada's greatest potential in research can only be realized when all Canadians are welcomed in the lab, in the field, and the classroom. Our government has always also placed a great emphasis on science and its role in decision making. We value and respect the work of our scientists and are committed to work together with them and to supporting them. It just makes sense. Science has the potential to improve the lives of people everywhere, especially those in the middle class and those working hard to join it. Investments in science and technology help spur economic growth, boost Canada's competitiveness, and ultimately create good paying middle-class jobs. We have already begun. We invested close to $2 billion to improve our research and innovation infrastructure at colleges and universities across Canada. These are the places where research and innovation happen, so they must be state-of-the-art. We have provided the largest boost in more than a decade to our granting councils to support more of the boundary-pushing research many of you here in this room are familiar with. We are investing in artificial intelligence, genomics, quantum computing, social innovation, space science, stem cell research, and the list goes on. We are doing this because we want to see more young Canadians, especially young Canadian women, getting the well-rounded education they need to start a good job after they graduate. And the work is not yet complete. Our government will continue to strongly support Canadian science and our amazing researchers. We are committed to promoting a more diverse, inclusive and welcoming research community in this country. Increasing diversity will help bring new perspectives to the lab and will enhance the richness of the discoveries and innovations that result. These are the kinds of discoveries that hold the potential to improve our world and support a strong middle class and a strong country. And the country is built when we have strong communities. On behalf of Minister Duncan and the Government of Canada, please accept my sincerest best wishes for a productive and rewarding conference. I thank you all for taking the time to be here today. I look forward to hearing about the conversations and discussions you are having. Please don't be strangers. If there's anything the government can do, let us know. We have a prime minister that is leading a country with colleagues, so we all work together really closely, and we believe in evidence-based decision-making. And as a woman in science, for me, the gray was always hard, and I always asked why, and now we have reasons why. So our number one reason as to why we do things, though, is our people. It's all of you. So whatever we can do, let us know. Keep doing the good work you're doing, and thank you so much for having me here.
Thank you, Bardish. It's always a pleasure to have you visit us. I'd like to now introduce Bob Lemieux, our Dean of Science since 2015. Bob is a professor of chemistry at the University of Waterloo, specializing in the design of advanced liquid crystal materials. So can you join me in welcoming Dean of Science, Bob Lemieux.
No, I got it. Thanks, Kevin. I also want to thank Bardish for being here this morning. It's always good to welcome you back in the Faculty of Science. You are certainly one of our most illustrious alumni, and we're very proud. I will start by saying that I want to echo what Bardish said about the need to have more women in government. I think that I couldn't agree more with that, but I will go farther and say we need more women scientists in government. And I think that the Trudeau government certainly has made great stride in doing so by having both Bardish and Kirsty Duncan in cabinet. I think that to have people who understand the importance of science, the importance of evidence-based decision-making is so critical in government. And I think in the current North American political context, I think that we realize now more than ever how important that is. So Bardish, we're always happy to have you back with us, and we're very proud to have you as a science grad. So thank you for being here this morning. And to all of you, welcome on behalf of the Faculty of Science to the 6th Annual Women in Physics Canada Conference. The Women in Physics Conference, as some of you may know, was first started in 2011 in Waterloo by Sarah Croke, who is a postdoctoral fellow at the Perimeter Institute, and Ed Broadbent, who was a postdoctoral fellow at IQC. And this is now a national conference that rotates among Canadian universities, and we're very pleased to have it return to the University of Waterloo, co-sponsored by the Department of Physics and Astronomy and by the Institute of Quantum Computing. As you know, there are many organizations promoting women in physics, including the International Conference for Women in Physics, sponsored by the IUPAP, as well as the Canadian Conference for Undergraduate Women in Physics. But the WIPC is unique in that its primary focus is on early career researchers, graduate students, and postdoctoral fellows in physics, astrophysics, and related fields. I'm very supportive of the goals of the WIPC conference to provide support for early career women researchers and to encourage them to continue a career in science. Of course, this is first and foremost a scientific conference, but beyond that, the conference will provide all of you with the opportunity to network with women in physics from across Canada to facilitate the sharing of experiences, ideas, and advice, and to foster a sense of community and belonging among participants. The Faculty of Science is very proud to support a number of other initiatives that promote women in science. And some of you may be aware that the University of Waterloo is the only Canadian member of the United Nations He for She campaign, and we're very proud of that. So in the Faculty of Science, we have an active Women in Science Club. We also have a Women in Physics Club, FemPhys, which won an Equity and Inclusivity Award in 2016. And we also had a recent APS site visit to physics and astronomy and IQC to promote and to improve the climate for women in physics. So as in the case of all conferences, this conference could not take place without the support of many sponsors. And I think you were supposed to see some of those sponsors up there, but maybe you will see them later on. I also want to acknowledge the organizers for putting this together. As I said, this is really a wonderful opportunity to promote women in physics. I should say, as Dean of Science, the one thing that pleased me a great deal is the increasing number of women who are in our academic programs in the Faculty of Science. And my hope is that this surge in interest and passion in science by women will continue through the process of graduate work and women becoming a greater presence in faculty, in faculties of science across the country and across the world. This is really important. We are making great strides, but we're not there yet. And we will continue to provide the right environment to allow women to achieve their dreams in scientific endeavors. So again, on behalf of the Faculty of Science, I want to welcome all of you to the University of Waterloo. We're very happy to have you here, and I wish you a great conference, a productive conference. So thank you again.